So, let's say you are out to buy a new monitor for your computer, a new TV for your living room, or whatever other reason you would buy a screen for. Now, not only do you have to take into consideration all the different display technologies and refresh rates, but also you have to deal with something a bit more simple: display resolution and display size. If you, for example, have to choose between a large but low resolution screen or a high resolution smaller screen, how do you do it? Well, let's check that out. Let's first go ahead and make sure that we are all on the same page by defining these two terms. Screen size refers to the diagonal length of a screen and is usually measured in inches. Resolution refers to the amount of pixels a screen has. It's usually expressed like 1920 by 1080, where 1920 is the width and 1080 is the height, in pixels of course. The common resolutions you will find on the market today are 1280 by 720, also called 720p or HD, 1920 by 1280, also called 1080p or Full HD, 2560 by 1440, also called 2K or 1440p, and 3840 by 2160, also called Ultra HD or 4K. Of course, all of those are for the 16:9 aspect ratio, and you can find other screens with other resolutions, such as the ultra-wide 21:9 aspect ratio, with resolutions such as 2560 by 1080 and 3440 by 1440, but let's not start listing every resolution in the world right now. Okay, so now that we have defined both of them properly, we can go ahead and discuss their importance when buying screens, especially monitors for your PC. Let's start by checking out the positives when it comes to both of them. Higher resolution has the benefit of giving you a sharper image, and also allowing you to fit more things on your screen at the same time. A larger screen is good if you find yourself often sitting far away from your display, because text and small details are usually larger on larger screens. Now let's look at the downsides. Higher resolutions require more powerful graphics cards to push all of those pixels, especially in graphically demanding applications such as gaming. Besides that, high resolution displays sometimes suffer from scaling issues, where text and other UI elements don't resize accordingly to the high pixel count and remain small and hard to read. When it comes to downsides of getting a larger screen without also upgrading the resolutions, the obvious disadvantage is that the image will undoubtedly become less clear and more blocky or blurry, as you may want to call it. So, the ideal scenario when getting a new monitor or upgrading to a better one would be to get a larger screen with a higher resolution for a better overall experience. But if your budget or any other constraints don't allow you to do so, what should you do? This is where we get to our conclusion for this video, which is one word, and that is retina. You see, retina is a term that Apple coined, which determines when the human eye can't see individual pixels anymore. At that point, you have the ideal ratio between screen size and resolution. This ratio is often referred to as PPI, pixels per inch, or pixel density. It tells you how closely pixels are packed together on your screen. A higher pixel density means a sharper image. However, if you make the display larger without increasing the resolution, you are effectively decreasing the pixel density. Let's have an example. This video that you are watching right now is 1080p, and this is a 720p image. Notice how making it larger just makes it all blocky, because the resolution is still 720p, we've just stretched it out a bit. Simultaneously, making the image smaller makes it look a bit sharper, because it's all more tightly packed right now. Now, retina depends on two things: your pixel density and how far away you are sitting from your display. My 29-inch 2560 by 1080 display becomes retina when I sit around 90 centimeters away from it, which is perfect because I sit about 85 centimeters away, and that's good enough. So, how do you figure this out? Well, you could go to isthisretina.com and tell it the resolution and size of your screen, and it will tell you at which distance your display becomes retina. Do of course take this with a grain of salt and give yourself a margin of error of about 10-ish centimeters. Then, take a look at how far away you are likely to be from your display. If your distance is equal to or higher than what the website tells you, it's good news. However, if you are closer to the display than what the calculator recommends, you might want to see about getting a higher resolution screen with the same size, or a smaller screen with the same resolution, in effect, you want to get higher pixel density to get the optimal experience for your viewing distance. So, hopefully you'll now be able to get the right balance between having a huge screen and a super high resolution. Now all that's left for me to say is I really hope you enjoyed this video, and if you want to see more, you can click on the right to watch my latest video, or on the left to watch a random video, or just click the round channel icon in the middle to subscribe. And as always, this has been Vlad from Goodsauce Tech, and I'll catch you in the next one. Take care, bye bye.